Here now, Representative Liz Cheney of Wyoming, daughter of former Vice President Dick Cheney during that era. Liz, good to see you. Thanks for being here this evening.
Good to be with you. I
want to ask you about that, but first I want to ask you about your reaction to the Iran deal, because I know that you have some thoughts on that tonight as well. So let's start there.
I think the president did exactly the right thing today. President Trump's decision to withdraw from the deal was courageous. It's perhaps the worst deal the United States has ever entered into, had no anywhere, anytime inspections, no access to military sites. The Iranians got to continue to enrich. It was actually a pathway to a nuclear weapon. It didn't prevent them from obtaining one. And the president was right. What he's done now is send a very clear message. We are not going to be bound by phony deals. We're not going to be in a situation where we're taken advantage of. And frankly, it sends a terrific message also to the North Koreans. It says, look, we are absolutely committed to making sure that the world's worst sponsor of terror does not get access to a nuclear weapon. It was a brave, courageous decision and exactly the right thing to do.
Interesting. All right. We'll see where that goes. Gina Haspel, tomorrow we do expect that there's going to be a lot of questions for her about her oversight of a black site in Thailand for one period during a very long career with the CIA. How would you advise her to handle those questions?
Look, I think that we've got an effort underway right now, which is frankly disgraceful. Gina Haspel is probably the most qualified person who's ever been nominated to head the CIA, the first career official in 52 years nominated for that position. Somebody who's got support across the board, Republicans, Democrats, career officials at the agency. She's someone who is known as having integrity, who's known as somebody who is absolutely committed to the security of this nation. And for the Democrats and for their allies in the media to be trying to smear her now with these attacks, I think, is really disgraceful. So I'm confident that she'll do well, and she ought to.
I ask you, some of the specifics in terms of the interrogation of KSM. This report from BuzzFeed says that he lied while he was being waterboarded, while these enhanced interrogation techniques were used on him. Abu Zubaydah, they say that he gave up the dirty bomb plot before he was waterboarded, and that they didn't get useful information out of him afterwards. These are the kind of questions that she's going to get.
Yeah, look, I think that there are, number one, I would urge people to go back. There's a 2004 report that was declassified by the CIA. The title of the report is KSM was the source of the vast majority of our knowledge at that point about Al-Qaeda. And it is simply not the case that he gave that information up prior to being waterboarded. So I would urge any of the senators who are going to oppose her, any of the senators who are going to stand up and say we shouldn't have waterboarded KSM, for example, they ought to be able to tell the American people how many American lives they're willing to sacrifice so they don't have to waterboard a terrorist. I wouldn't be willing to sacrifice any American lives for that. And there's a big effort now to rewrite history, a big effort to try to claim this program didn't work. But we know the program gave us information that helped save lives. We also know the program gave us clues that led directly to helping identify the location of Osama bin Laden. And CIA directors have said that from both parties throughout the period of time since the program started and also was ended. So it was a good program and it worked.
Well, and it's always, the benefit of time, you have to really put yourself back in those moments as well. Liz Cheney, thank you so much. It's good to see you. Thanks for being here tonight.
You too, Martha.